What's going on, YouTube? I know it's been a while since I've made a video, but I'm here with something really neat today. We're gonna do an unboxing of my new camera. It's a ZWO ASI1600 Monochrome Cooled Pro. That's a mouthful of a camera name, but it's also one hell of a camera to have. A lot of astrophotographers are using this camera with great success. Chuck from Chuck's Astrophotography has been using this camera for at least a year, and he puts out some of the best astrophotography I've ever seen. So even though he never recommended it, his work speaks for itself, and that was the driving force behind why I went with the camera that I picked. Before I actually do this unboxing, I want to make it very clear right now, I am not sponsored or affiliated with High Point Scientific or ZWO. I paid for my own products and I test them so I can be as unbiased as possible. Now, let's get into the unboxing. Alexa, play some royalty-free music that is appropriate for YouTube. This is the box as I received it from High Point Scientific. Okay, I had to do a camera reset for a minute. I realized when I opened the flaps on this originally that there was a packing slip with my address clearly visible, so I had to take that out. And in the process, the camera shut itself off. I had to pull it down, turn it back on. So the angle looks a little funny. I apologize about that. Let's go ahead and get in and take a look at how High Point packages the camera before they send it to you. Right away, we've got the AC adapter, I'm assuming. This is so I can run the cooled camera. A lot of packing peanuts here. And I don't have anywhere for these to go, so they're just gonna go all over the place. I will say that it looks like High Point does a good job making sure that there's about 1 to 2 inches of packaging or filler around the external box and the internal box. A fun fact that people don't know about the shipping industry is if you ship something with UPS, it's going to be insured for $100 right off the bat. And you get that for free with everything that you buy as part of your regular shipping. But if you insure something for more than $100, you pay a premium on that. Now, I did not insure this at all. When it came, I didn't have the option. But if you file a claim because of damaged goods with UPS or FedEx, the first thing that they're gonna wanna investigate is the packaging. And was there an external box with at least 1 to 2 inches of some sort of padding around the inner box and the outer box? And if the answer is no, your claim is immediately denied. And so High Point Scientific giving you all of those packing peanuts around the outside of this box, they're taking that into account. Okay, so the inner box should have the camera and filter wheel and the filters. And this is the electronic filter wheel. It's the 8-position carousel. I picked the 1.25 inch filters. I've got a 7 nanometer hydrogen alpha filter, 7 nanometer oxygen 3 filter, and the 7 nanometer sulfur 2. Vacuum packed LRGB filter set from ZWO. And the main event. It is indeed the 1600mm Pro USB 3.0 camera made in China, which we all know ZWO is probably one of the best Chinese camera manufacturers out there. All right, let's take a look at this filter wheel first. I don't need my knife for that. This feels pretty robust. It's all metal. It's not as thick as I thought it would be. I have the manual filter wheel I bought with my 174 about 3 or 4 years ago. And again, that one's all metal as well, but it doesn't have nearly the weight that this does. And I'm pretty sure the weight comes from the electronics that are in here. I don't see a grub screw here to put pressure on that compression ring, but that might be in another package inside of here. USB 2.0 cable. So it's interesting that I get a USB 2.0. It's even printed on the side that this is USB 2.0 for a 3.0 camera, but this may be for the filter wheel. So I got a couple of screws here. Looks like I've got a nose piece adapter that would go on the back of the filter wheel. That's really loud. That sounds really rough. It doesn't sound like the threads were very clean when they anodized this or whatever. Looks like I got another little extension ring here, maybe a 10 millimeter. A ton of little screws and a bunch of shims. All right, filters. So there's the S2 filter. It does say S2 7 nanometers on the edge of the filter, which is nice. It'll help me identify that later. This is the O3. It says 7 nanometer O3 on the side of it as well. And the 7 nanometer hydrogen alpha. And then the LRGB set. Filters tell me which one is luminance, red, green, and blue. And just so you know, looking at that head on, let's see, there we go. So this is luminance. One here is red, this one here is green, and this one here is blue. This is the AC adapter. This is necessary if you want to run the cooled thermal electric cooling. It's an AC adapter, takes regular wall current using this computer power cable here. Goes into that port right there on the power brick. Power brick converts that from 100 to 240 volt input at 1.5 amps to a 12 volt, 5 amp, 60 watt max output. The nice thing about this being that it's 12 volt is I can go find out what the dimensions are for this coax, and I can make my own Anderson power pole 12 volt cable for it that will run from my rig runner. I'm gonna keep this around anyway, just in case I'm in my driveway and I wanna run an extension cord out and go off of the mains. And now for the main event. A little bit more styrofoam. Oh, good. I was hoping I would get the case that came with it. So the camera's gonna be in here. I've got a USB 3.0 cable, and this one's easy to recognize because it's got the blue tips to it. I've got what looks to be a 5 millimeter spacer ring. I have a short USB 2.0 cable. I'm assuming that this short cable is what's supplied with every 1600. In the event that you go with a electronic filter wheel, they give you a cable for it. I've got a nose piece adapter, a 21 millimeter extension tube, which is really handy. That'll thread on, I believe that's about a 42 millimeter diameter. This will help you achieve back focus if they're already giving you the proper 21 millimeter extension ring. I've got a 16.5 millimeter extension ring. The two will thread together, and if they do, that gives you 37.5 millimeters of extension. If you need that much back focus. What looks like a couple more shims and a quick guide owner's manual. They give you different configurations. This little handy flow chart here. Reminds me of how Takahashi has their, the way that their adapters with their focal reducers and field flatteners work. And let's take a look at this camera here. Wow, this is massive. It's a lot bigger than the photos online show it out to be. It's about as big around as a soup can. Okay, so we have a heat sink right in the side of the body here. So that's gonna be optimal for airflow. We've got the fan here. Don't know if it's a pusher or a puller fan. I would imagine it's a pull fan instead of a push. And the benefit, I guess, of having the heat sink flush with the outside is if you were to use a smaller heat sink inside and then cut vanes here for the air to escape, you're gonna run into airflow problems. You're going to be trying to force air through a heat sink on the inside and then trying to force that through a grilled interface on the outside, where you can eliminate that by just having the heat sink vanes go straight to the outside of the camera body like it does here. We see here on the back side, again, there's the fan, the DC 12 volt 3 amp input. I'm assuming that's for the thermal electric cooling. I've got two USB 2.0 output ports here. These do have a USB 2.0 hub built on the inside. My USB 3.0 input, and then the business end. There's the sensor. Now let's just see how well a filter lines up with that sensor. Supposedly this is not supposed to cause any vignetting. And that's gonna be kind of hard to show, but it does not look like it will. So there it is. ZWO ASI1600 monochrome cooled pro camera. Now, the neat thing about these pro cameras is they've got built-in RAM. The memory that they build into these cameras is there. It's supposed to help reduce any artifacts from reading the image from the sensor on a slow USB read. It can snap it right into the memory, then download it from memory, and you don't get like amp glow. It's supposed to eliminate a lot of the readout noise. And I've got a dog that wants to go outside, so we're gonna go ahead and end this video here. Look forward to showing you more of these videos in the future where I'm using this camera, setting it up, and producing astrophotography that's on par with some of the best that are out there. Until next time, clear skies.